So maybe you've heard about this new Android version known as Oreo. It's a pretty silly name for software, I know. That's Google for you, but cookie connotations aside, there's a lot to digest about Android's latest update, and some of its most interesting additions are things you probably won't even notice right away. All right, time to peel apart Oreo's layers and get into a few of its most meaningful front-facing features. First up, notification snoozing. I really love this one. When you get a notification and don't want to deal with it right away, just slide it slightly to the left or to the right. You see that little clock icon that shows up on the edge? Tap it. By default, that'll send your notification away for an hour and then have it reappear as if it were new. Next up, picture-in-picture mode. This is a really cool new option that's actually pretty useful in the real world. Google Maps is a great place to try it out. Go into Maps and start navigating somewhere. Then hit your device's Home or Overview button, and look at that, your navigation automatically shrinks down into a little box. It'll float on top of whatever else you do. You can move it around, enlarge it, go back to full screen, or when you're done, just fling it away to dismiss it. Picture-in-picture works really well with YouTube, too, though you do have to have an active YouTube Red subscription for it to happen. If you don't, though, don't worry. It also works with any video you play full screen from Chrome, even videos from, oh yes, YouTube.com. Another neat feature worth exploring is Oreo's notification channel system. This one seems kind of complicated, but it's actually pretty powerful and not that hard to figure out once you wrap your head around it. With apps that support the feature, you can long press on a notification and then get really granular control over exactly how and when the app's able to alert you. These are the notification channels for Maps. Instead of just having a single on-off switch, you can go in and pick and choose what types of notifications the app is able to send you, and how each of those notifications behaves. Probably not something an average Android user is ever gonna mess with, but for those of us who like to take control, it's a great new way to make your notifications less noisy and more useful for your own personal needs.